Hello students, hope you're doing fine at home and are in good health. So welcome back. Today we are here once again to learn something new. So the next lesson that we are going to learn is components of environment. Okay, now what is environment? Let's quickly understand and what are components to it. Okay, the surroundings are the conditions of organisms, right? It both includes natural and cultural element and hence are termed as natural environment and cultural environment. So whatever surroundings we see besides us forms the environment. Okay, the word environment connotes the surrounding or external conditions influencing the development or growth of people, animals or plants. In other words, the physical or biological conditions in which a living organism lives collectively makes up its environment. The environment created by natural as well as culture. Okay, so the environment is made up of but two things, natural as well as cultural. So natural environment is the environment created by nature. Clear? It includes the physical properties of the place where an organism lives, its climate, soil, minerals, etc., as well as other organisms. Natural environment has basically two components, abiotic and biotic. So abiotic means non-living and biotic means living. Abiotic components includes elements like sunlight, air, water, soil, moisture, etc. Biotic components include plants and animals. I hope this is clear. Both the components of environment, that is biotic and abiotic, are inseparable. Inseparable, this means you cannot separate them. They interact with each other all the time. If any change occurs in physical or natural environment, it changes the biological environment too. Moreover, these components of environment are not static or fixed. They are always changing because of various processes. These changes may be slow as well as sudden. Culture or human environment, on the other hand, includes all those elements or features that have been created by man during various stages of the development of human civilization. Thus, houses, farms, roads, factories, means of communication, etc. are all included in human environment. So whatever human has made or the human culture has made, this is all man-made, correct? Environment varies from place because physical conditions like relief and climate are different at each place. Environment largely determines the mode of life of people in a region. Differences in food, clothes, shelter, and economic activities reflect the differences of natural environment. Every component of an organism's natural environment is important for the organism's well-being. Any change in its environment affects an organism. The natural environment is in turn affected by the actions of the organism. So the natural environment is attached to the cultural also, right? So any changes to any of the environment will affect the organism. Okay? Although changes in nature alter the natural environment, the components of natural environment remain more or less the same over a long period of time. For example, men and animals release carbon dioxide through respiration and add to the atmosphere. Green plants, on the other hand, take in carbon dioxide from the atmosphere during photosynthesis. So now, what is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process by plants. Okay, it's a chemical process. Plus, there is light energy involved in it. Okay, so when we say green plants give us oxygen, right? So oxygen is a byproduct of the photosynthesis process by plants. Okay. Thus, the amount of carbon dioxide remains almost the same in atmosphere. Thus, small changes are naturally balanced. We cannot think of an area or a region where natural or cultural environment do not exist together. In fact, both are inseparable because man is an important part of the environment. He affects and is also affected by environment. He utilizes the natural resources of the environment to sustain himself and thus creates cultural environment. In the beginning, he was completely dependent on nature for his survival. Late, he developed skills and modified his environment to fulfill his needs. Instead of hunting and food gathering, he began to grow food. He cleared forests to make farm for agriculture. Later he began mining and set up industries. In the process, he changed natural environment altogether and created a new one, that is cultural environment. Alright? Now, since it was all natural, there were forests, man cut trees, and then he made farms. Man got into industrialization, he went ahead for mining was done, and then industries were set up. Okay, so this type of environment made by man is called cultural environment altogether. Now we come to the point, need to protect our environment. The need, why is the need to protect it? So let's see. Ever since the dawn of civilization, man has been continuously altering his natural environment. So what is man doing? Man is continuously changing the natural environment, right? His economic activities have led to permit these kind of permanent changes in the environment, right? Man wants to have more money, that's the reason he is trying to move ahead to have a good economy, right? That's the reason he is changing all natural environment. This excessive changes have harmfully affected the natural environment of organisms. The need to protect our environment stems from the following facts. Environment is a basic life support system. It provides us air, water and food, which are essential for our life. So why do we need to protect the environment? Because we get food, water, air from environment, natural environment. So we need to protect it. So they say you need to plant more trees and take care of trees, because trees are good friends of human beings. Environment provides us many useful resources such as wood, fuel, minerals, energy, etc. So the natural environment, what does it give? It gives us many useful things like the wood. Wood is used to cook food, heat water, right? Fuel, you have petrol and diesel and coal, different minerals like iron, energy, coal energy, right? All the economic activities of man adversely affect the environment. Irrational use of our natural resources like forests, pastures, agricultural land and minerals have already damaged the environment. If we do not check the irrational use of a resource, it will have a serious consequences for mankind. So we need to be very careful in using our resources. We cannot keep on simply wasting petrol and diesel, because these are very, very valuable things given to us by nature. Now we come to the domains or the spheres of environment, right? The environment may be broadly divided into four major domains or spheres, namely atmosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere and biosphere. Okay, now let's see what atmosphere is. Atmosphere is a gaseous envelope surrounding the earth. It is very dynamic in nature. The elements of atmosphere such as temperature, pressure, winds, humidity, rainfall, etc. combine to produce weather and climate, both of which affect natural process, soil formation, natural vegetation, animal life, and above all, life and activities of man. So this is what atmosphere is. So atmosphere is all made up of a gaseous envelope around the earth. So remember, when we say atmosphere, it means the air around us. Okay. The atmosphere has several layers, each having distinct properties and utility. You will read about these layers in the later chapter. The atmosphere is attached to the earth by force of gravitation. It protects us from scorching heat and ultraviolet radiations of the sun. It provides necessary conditions for the existence and growth of all forms of life on earth. So atmosphere, the air we breathe, is very important. We need to keep it clean, right? It also protects us from the tough heat of the sun. Now moving ahead, we will now study lithosphere. So the word litho means rock, right? Rock or stone. Lithosphere is the layer of the earth which consists of rock materials. It extends both over the continents and ocean basin. The average thickness of the lithosphere is about 100 kilometers. It is composed of rock rich in silica, aluminium, magnesium, iron, and many other minerals. The uppermost layer of the lithosphere is known as crust, which consists of a variety of rocks. We will read more about these rocks later. So, lithosphere is normally a thick layer of the earth, which is approximately 100 kilometers in breadth, in thickness. Okay, and this has got different metals and different minerals in it. Lithosphere is very important for us because it provides us land to live. So where do we construct a building or a house? We do it on the ground. So if you have seen a new construction going on, you can see lot of stones coming out, lot of big rocks coming out when a new house is to be constructed, right? It also provides us many minerals which are essential for economic development. So you get a lot of iron, lot of aluminium and magnesium from lithosphere. This has monetary value. This gives us a good amount of money. Okay, so we need to take care of lithosphere also. Most of human activities are confined to this domain of environment. So many human activities like digging, mining for different types of minerals, different types of fuel is done on the lithosphere. Now we move ahead, we come to hydrosphere. The word hydro means water. Okay, hydrosphere is the realm of water. It includes all water bodies as oceans, lakes, river, etc. It covers nearly 71% of the earth's surface. So the hydrosphere is spread out on earth and it covers 71% of the earth's surface. Okay, the earth is known as the watery planet or the blue planet because it has abundance of water. Lots of water is there, that's the reason the earth is also called as the watery planet or a blue planet. Oceans are the largest water bodies on earth. They are very important to us because they link variety of land masses. Besides, they play a major role in determining the climate and the hydrological cycle. Oceans generally have a moderate effect on climate of the coastal region. Oceans are also important as storehouse of food. Now, you know where the cloud comes from? The cloud comes from these oceans and seas. Okay, after heating, the water rises up and then slowly converts into clouds, and then the clouds travel to different parts of the land and it rains, right? So it is very important for us. Secondly, you get a lot of fish, lot of seafood from oceans. So oceans are also important as a storehouse of food. They provide us with fish and other seafood like lobster, crabs, etc. They also contain many useful minerals in their bed. Large deposits of petroleum and natural gas also occur in sedimentary basins of the oceans. So you get a lot of fuel also in the bottom of the oceans. Oceans are useful for navigation and also for conducting international trade. So when we talk about international trade, we see that big ships sail in big oceans, right? Hence oceans are very important to us. Rivers and lakes are important fresh water bodies which provide us potable water. Potable means water that can be taken for drinking, used by for many purposes including irrigation. These water bodies are very important and crucial for the survival of all human beings. It's very important. Water, we say jal hi jeevan hai, so this is the part of it, right? Biosphere. Now we'll study what is biosphere. Biosphere is also called ecosphere, is the domain of life. Okay, it is a very narrow zone of the earth where lithosphere, atmosphere and hydrosphere come into contact with each other. It is a life supporting layer which surrounds the earth and makes plant and animal life possible. It contains all living organisms. The average thickness of this layer is about 30 kilometers. So the thickness of this particular layer, biosphere, is 30 kilometers. Most of the plant and animals are found on or near the surface of the land. It is important to note that marine life is concentrated near the surface where food in the form of plants is available. Marine life is, however, different from land on life. Microorganisms live in the atmosphere, hydrosphere and lithosphere. Thus, biosphere is a narrow zone of life where all forms of life exist on earth. So things would be different in different parts of the land. However, biosphere is one big ecosphere. Okay, now moving ahead, now we come to the last part of the lesson, which is biodiversity. Biodiversity means the wide range of species of plants and animals. Life form has evolved on the earth and got diversified during the past millions of years. This process of diversification has given rise to different species of plants and animals. There are 3.5 million species of plant and 11 million species of animal. Human activists have caused degradation of the environment and loss of biodiversity, as several species of plant and animals are already extinct and many others are facing the danger of extinction. So, dear students, we need to be very careful for our near future, keeping in mind that Mother Nature is very caring for us. We should also be caring for her. Hope you understood this lesson. Thank you so much. Take care.